Summertime Bigfoot. This is video 3 of the narrative, a short narrative series that I'm doing, explaining where to look in some of these videos for people to see the point of interest or a possible creature that's been captured in the video. And I'm taking the videos that are most asked about, and this is actually video 3, so let's take a look at it. The video is called Found Where Our Friend Was Spying From, and the reason I called it that is because this is the second day of a situation that was happening. I was out in the forest with all my sons sitting out there, and I was out in the forest with three of my sons, and there were some sounds coming from these blackberry bushes that are everywhere out there. It sounded like something was watching us, but I kind of disregarded it. And the next day we came out, and I thought, just to prove it to myself, we're going to go walk through those berry bushes and see if there's anything to be seen in there. And we're walking around, and we found a spot where something had been standing and presumably watching us. I'm not sure where in the video that part is.
Activity. I'm sitting way over there.
I think we're standing there right now.
We were hearing some sounds back in this area, and now I'm on this
side. I'm trying to explain in the video what had happened.
Of the bushes and stuff. And I come up.
And this is the spot where something had been standing. It was obvious at the time that there was a couple of foot impressions here, and they don't really show up in the video very well. But this isn't really the interesting part of the video. The interesting part starts way down here at about 4 minutes. Somewhere down here. Okay, we're about the right spot. Let's make it a little bigger.
Maybe that's the spot where something was.
So what you're going to see is that my older son is over here doing something. I'm not sure. He's looking at stuff. And I'm over here on this side of the trees. And I say, I got this cool, weird feeling, or something to that effect. And very soon after that, you'll see this creature. There's my son.
Cool.
See, I'm saying I got this cool, weird feeling. Which is something I'd like to explain, that I do get quite a bit when these situations arise. I'm going to zoom in on this a little bit. The creature is right there. And what you're seeing is that there's two trees. It's not very obvious there's two trees, but there is. There's a smaller one and there's a slightly bigger one, and the creature's standing behind them. And it's weird that I'm saying I get this weird feeling, because look how close I was to this creature. So, okay, let's progress it a little bit here. You're going to see the creature move without the camera moving. See? He's now stuck his head away out. This is the creature, right here. And just so we have a scale here, there is a tree branch, which is kind of difficult to make out, but it's a tree branch right here, at that level. And there's another one right here. I've been out there many times, and when I stand there, my head is below the upper tree branch. And when you measure how tall this creature must be, he's approaching 8 feet tall, which is quite large. Okay, let's just keep watching. See?
Well, just stay away from the trails. We're not here to explore.
And see, the creature pulls back. He pulled back in behind the trees as he sees my head looking this way. So he pulls back before my eyes can see him.
I'm just looking for a spot we can.
I'm looking around. The creature's still there. He's got his head out. This is not some sort of camera trickery or anything like this. And look, you can see a bunch of his body on both sides of this small tree. And if you look carefully, you can see him beyond the second tree as well. And just so people know where the spot is, this is the tree in a video. The second tree here is the video that was pulled down and broken up into pieces. My son climbed up in that tree in one video this year, and we're trying to get a look at something we had seen back in the forest. Anyways, that tree doesn't exist anymore. It's laying there all broken up. Okay, let's keep watching.
Get out of here. Okay, so.
See, I'm looking over there now. creature's not there.
We're gonna film me stringing the apples up here.
And see, he just he comes out, he pulls back. Let's just kind of go back a bit to see that again. I wish I could do this in slow motion.
Okay. So we're gonna film me.
Okay, where is he?
Stringing the apples up.
He's right there. You watch right there. He's gonna move. I think he moves out a little bit, and he pulls back again.
Up here.
See? He's pulled back, and it really didn't have anything to do with the camera's motion whatsoever. Whoops.
Four apples were all taken, but it was at a location about 12 kilometers.
There he is. He's still there.
I thought for sure there's gonna be a lot of activity, but needless to say, I found this place has a lot of activity, and I haven't been able to go back out there.
And that's the last we see of the creature in this video. You know, it's kind of eerie when I look back at this because, you know, I climbed up this tree, I hung these apples there. We were there about 20 minutes, and that creature must have been there the entire time because we never heard anything leave. We never saw anything. We were completely oblivious to this. And this is what goes on in the forest while we're out there. You know, the creature is almost invisible. He's almost able to do whatever he wants without being detected. And again, if I had seen that creature there, there is no way we would have been standing there putting apples up in the tree for the creature to take away. So now you've seen it. So now you know where to look in this video. The video is called Found Where Our Friend Was Spying From. And the interesting parts started around the 4 minute mark to about the 4 minute and 46 second mark. So hope you enjoy it. Timber Giant Bigfoot.